Welcome back to Snap Circuits SC750 Extreme, and today we're going to be building another project number 614, the open and close indicator. And this is light controlled, so the objective is to construct a circuit that indicates if a door is open or closed using light. Okay, this looks like a fairly simple one, though it does require that huge segment display, so yeah, I wouldn't call it so simple. Okay, so let's begin with the two batteries. Here we go. The first one's gonna go all the way down by E9, looks like. The second one's gonna go all the way up here. And I have to make sure I get the orientation correct today. And, A what? A7. Okay. Yes, now that was a bit weird. Okay, I think that's how it's supposed to go right there. It might need to go in the reverse orientation. Yeah, it needs to go like this, I think. Okay, well now, we're gonna have a huge 7 running along the bottom of the board here. I think this is a 7, yeah. This is how long it is, it's crazy. Going from G1 to G7, looks like. Okay, and next we're going to have another long piece, a 6, down here. Not really down here, it's way up at A1. Right over here. Probably a long strip so far. Okay, and next we're going to have an Q2 NPN right here, transistor, going at D2. There you go. Alright, and then, Well, it's not a lot of level 1 parts, are there? I think that's it for level 1. Oh no, we missed a 3 going at D1 over here. D1. But I think that is it for level 1 parts. That was quite quick. And now level 2 parts, we have 2 resistors coming in. An R4 and an R5 right here. The R5 is a brown, white, yellow, black, brown, I think. I'm not quite sure. It's very hard to see. And then the R4 is a gold, white, orange, black, orange, not orange, brown. It's very hard to tell. But the R4 goes over between. Whoa, wait a second. Huh? Oh, we're fine. Okay, so this R4 goes over here. Let's go to the right orientation. And then the R5 goes up here between the Q2 and the 6. Okay. And next, we're going to have another 3 between... The 7-segment display was a level 1 part that we completely forgot. Okay, so let me put that in at C4. That's huge. Not so far. Okay, and next, we're going to have... Let's see. That 3 I was talking about. Between the plus pin and this 6 here. I see where this is going now. That's going to jump to the battery here from the 7-segment display. And then we get a 2 here and we put it between the battery and the 6 to jumper it. And then we get a 5 more jumpering between batteries. Between this B1 and this other B1. So to call it a B1. They're both B1s. Ow! Okay, and now we're going to have an S1 slide switch. As you know, it looks like this. And then it's going to go right over here between this... Whoops, the 7 is backwards, but it's fine. I don't think it really makes a difference anyway. Okay, and now we're going to want a 1. We're going to want a 1 right here on this 7. So that later we can put a 2 right there, it looks like. Alright, but first, we're going to need... The RP photoresistor. I never really understood why they called it RP, because photoresistor should be PR. I don't know why, but this basically detects light coming in, and yeah. Whoops, something is not right. Yeah, okay, I misplaced this 3 here. This 3 is actually supposed to go up to the C. I was gonna say, this thing won't reach. Got a bit confused earlier about that, too. Okay, now we just put the photoresistor up here. And Doesn't really matter which order it is, it's in, I don't think. Okay, kind of nice. And next, let's see. Looks like we're going to want a 1 on the on the B pin of the 7-segment display. Okay. And we're going to want another 1 on the C pin of the 7-segment display. And then, oh my god, this is getting complicated. We're going to want a 2 here. We're going to want a 2 between the A and F pins of the 7-segment display. And then we're going to want another 2 between the E and D pins of the 7-segment display. Okay. And next, we need another 2 between this Q2MPN and this 3 over here. It looks like so far. Okay. And next, we're going to need, let's see. Is that it for level 2 parts? Nope, there's another 3. We've depleted all our 3s in the main box. Now we're moving on to reserve supply. Between this MPN Q2 and this 7 down here. There we go. And is that it? It might just be for level 2 parts, that is. Okay, let's call that it for level 2 parts. I don't see anything else. So now level 3 parts include a 3. I'm gonna have to go digging now because we're only in reserve parts now. Hope we don't need much more 3s because we're gonna be out of them. We're gonna want a 3 between, oh yeah, these two 1s here, right there. And then we're gonna want, let's see, a 2 between this other 2 and this 1 on the 7. Alright, that didn't seem to go in too well. Oh, but now it's fine. And then, it looks like, what next? Yeah, we need another 2 between two 2s. Oh my god, look at all these 2s on this 7-segment display. God. Okay, it's like a trail of 2s. Okay, and next, we're gonna need a 1 on this left pin of the R5 resistor, it looks like. And then we're gonna need, is that it for level 3 parts already? I can't believe this. Yeah, it looks like it. Okay, well now it's time for the 1 level 4 part. It's gonna go between this R5 resistor and this thing over here. It's kind of like a bridge. What it looks like here. Okay, well I guess that's it. So what are you supposed to do? Switching from letters O to C requires turning off segments B and C. Okay, so turn on the slide switch. It says O right now. Yep, an O indicating an open door. Cover, okay, I'm gonna cover the photoresistor. Let me show you this. See, it says closed right now. See that C there? I don't know why I did that. Whenever I set it down, I'm gonna pick the phone up to show you. Okay. Oh, see the right here. See if you can see this. That means open right there. I'm gonna put my hand over the photoresistor. Watch. Yep, it changes to C. Yep, C and O. C being closed. Okay, now let me just switch off the lights in here and see how it changes. Okay, it says C now, and it's very easy to see. So there's our big C, meaning it's closed. So what this is supposed to do is, I guess, whenever you just put it like near a door or something, and whenever you open the door, you turn on a light probably, and that light comes onto this photoresistor here. Now, this won't work, probably, if there's already a light outside. So, like, if you're in a dark hallway, which I'll show you in a second. If you're in a dark hallway, and then you go into a room that has no light, and then you turn on the light in there, then it will change the signal to O. Otherwise, it'll be closed. Okay, so this will be a little bit tricky to demonstrate, but let me go and turn off the light in the hallway real fast. So that we can demonstrate this, I'm going to shut the blinds. And I'm going to turn the light off in here, so that you can easily see. Let's see, okay, right now it says C, as you can see. Let me take this thing. out into the hallway. Okay, so I'm gonna place it right by the door here, like your average sensor. So it's, if you can't tell, it says C right now. It says C, and let's say I were to carry it into the room, like at night or something. Like if a burglar's coming in or something. This is gonna be very hard to demonstrate. I'm gonna hold the phone right here, and I'm gonna turn on the light in the room and watch it change to O. Nope, it didn't. I guess it needs to be closer to the light source in the room. Let me push it forward. There we go. That's better. Too bad you can't really see that easily. Okay. It still says C. I don't know what that's about. You can see the C there. Oh, there it goes. Okay, so what you need to do in order for it to say O is you need to slightly tilt it up. So tilt it up and it'll say O. Okay, let's try this again. Again, say like a burglar's coming in. It says C right now. And then you can say that. And then we're going to have the light turned on here. And then you can see it changes to O there. The segments light up just barely. Yep, there you go. Okay, so we now have an open door indicator there. That's properly functioning. Let me set it back on the table. Alright. And that was project number 614 of SnapCircuit SC750 Extreme, the open and close indicator, which is properly functioning, although it's probably best if you do it in a dark room and then turn on the light. Otherwise, it won't really work. But yes, that was open and close indicator. And we'll see you for the next SnapCircuit project.